fraction. Okay, so write this ratio as a fraction. 55 is to 65. Means 55 upon 65. Now this we have to write in the lowest term. For to do the lowest term, what we have to do? We have to divide for numerator as well as denominator with the same number. Okay, we have to divide for the numerator as well as denominator with the same number. Okay. So now if you will observe, start observing the number, both the numbers are at this one space is 5. So this both the numbers are divisible by 5. So you can divide by 5 and you can write, if you want to do directly, you can write it directly. So 5 ones are 55 divided by 5. 5 ones are 5, 5 ones are 5. Here 5 ones are 5, 5 threes are 15. Those who knows directly, they can do it like this way. 5 ones are 5, 5 ones are 5, 5 ones are 5, 5 threes are 15. They can write this. If you don't know, they can do by showing division. Divide by 5 for the numerator also, divide by 5 for the denominator also. Okay, if you will divide for 55 by 5, you will get 11. If you will divide for 65 by 5, you will get 13. So, what is that number? 11 upon 13. So, write each of the following ratio in lowest term. So, what it is? 11 is to 13. So next example, 169 is to 117. Now 169 is to 117, let's write this ratio as a fraction. Okay, in the form of fraction. See, 169 upon 117. Now 169 is the square of 13. This number is divisible by 13. And 117 is there in the 13 table. Everyone knows table. Those who knows the table, it is easy for them. 169 is the square of 13. If you will do the square of 13, what is the square of 13? 169. Okay. And 117 is there in which table? It is there in 13 table. So both the numbers are divisible by 13. So let's divide by 13 for numerator also and for denominator. Here I will show you the division. 169 divided by 13. 13 ones are 30. 6 minus 3, 3. 1 minus 1, 0. 9 will come down. 33 are 39. See, it is divisible by 13 or not. So what we got answer when we divide for 169 by 13? That time what we got question? 13 we got question. Now let's divide for 117 by 13. Okay. 13 nines are 117. Okay. So here what we will get? 9. Okay. So 13 upon 9 means what we have got here? 13 is to 9. So what we got here? 13 is to 9. Okay. Let's solve question number 2. Write the ratio for each of the following. See, this is first one question. 15 paise is 2 rupees 1 and 75 paise. Now see, this is given ratio. It is, see, here it is given in paise and here it is given in rupees. So units are different. So let's make the units same. Okay, paise is the smaller unit and rupees is the standard unit. So, standard unit we will convert into smaller unit. Means what we will do? Rupees we will convert into paise. First we have to make the unit same and then we have to find the ratio. Okay, so now rupees 1 and 75 paise. See, this we are going to convert into paise. 1 rupees means 100 paise. For this we will multiply by 100. Why we multiply by 100? Because 1 rupees is equal to 100 paise. Why we have to multiply by 100? Why we have to multiply by 100? Because 1 rupees is equal to 100 paise. So we have to multiply by 100 paise for this. Okay. So what we will get the answer? 175. See, we are multiplying by 100. Okay, when we multiply, we have to shift from left towards right in 2 digits. So So here it is decimal point. We are multiplying by 100. So 2 digits means where it will come decimal point here. Okay. So 175 paise. Here it is there means if you will not give even though. Okay. So 175 paise. Okay. So paise we got. So now what we have to do? We got the same unit. 15 paise is to 175 paise. Now don't do like this. First take 175 paise is to 15 paise. Okay. Don't do like this. This is wrong. What it is asked? 15 paise is to rupees 175 paise. We convert rupees into paise. So which ratio we will find? 15 paise is to 175 paise. 175 paise. See, 15 paise is to rupees 175 paise. Rupees we convert into paise. So we have to find the ratio of 15 paise is to 175 paise. So let's find the ratio. So write here required ratio. Required ratio is equal to 15 paise. So 15 upon 175. Okay. So now both the numbers are divisible by 5 as its whole space is 5. Both the numbers are divisible by 5. Okay. So if you will divide by 5 for the numerator as well as denominator. See, 5 threes are 15. See here, 5 threes are 15, 5 fives are 25. If you don't know, this way you can do in rough. Divide by 5 for 175, 5 threes are 15. 7 minus 5, 2. 1 minus 1, 0. 5 come down. 5 fives are 25. Okay, so what we got here? 35 we got here. Okay, so what we have got here? 3 upon 35. 3 upon 35. Now again see these both the numbers are divisible by any same number? No. So what ratio we got? 3 is to 35. So which ratio we have got? 3 is to 35. Now let's solve question number 2. 13.6 kg is to 1020 gram. Now see here it is given in kilogram and here it is given in gram. So let's make unit same. Okay, here it is given in kilogram, here it is given in gram. Okay, so now kilogram we will convert into gram. Kilogram we will convert into gram. Okay, so what we have to do to convert kilogram into gram? 1 kilogram is 1000 gram. See, if you don't know, you use that triangle. And see, kilogram convert into gram. We are going up. Going up means multiply. Okay, so multiply by 1000. Okay, so 13.6 kg we are going to convert into gram. So multiply by 1000 for this. Okay, so what we will get? 13.6. Okay, multiply by 1000. Multiplying by 1000. So, what we will get the answer? 0, 0. Here it will come decimal point. Where it will come decimal point? Here it will come decimal point. We have to shift towards right. Okay, we have to shift towards right. Okay, so where it will come? Here it will come decimal point. So what we got? Gram. So what we got? Gram. 13,600 gram we got. Now what we have to find? 13.6 kg. 13.6 kg we convert into gram. So right here, this gram, 13,600 gram is to 1020 gram. Okay, see, we convert kilogram into gram. We convert kilogram into gram. So what we got? 13,600 gram. Okay, it's to 1020 gram. Now let's find the ratio for this. So write here required ratio. Required ratio is equal to 13,600 gram. It's to 1020 gram. Okay, now see, 0, this 0 get cancelled. Now what will remain here? Upon 102. Now see, x1 plus is 0, x1 plus is 2. So both the numbers are divisible by 2. Yes, 2 5s are 10, 2 1s are 2, here 2 6s are 12. 2 8s are 16, 2 0s are 0. If you will not understand, you can do by this way. Divide by 2, 2 6s are 12. Okay, 3 minus 2, 1, 1 minus 1, 0. 6 will come down, 2 8s are 16. Okay, now 0 will come down, 2 0s are 0. So 618 we got. Okay, so after that, now see what we got, 680 upon 15. Now find both the numbers are divisible by which same number? 17. See, 17 threes are 51. And divide by 17 for these also. 17 fours are 68. Okay. So now this 0 will come down. 17 zeros are 0. So what we got here? 40. Okay. So we have got here 40 upon 3. 40 upon 3 means what is the ratio? 40 is to 3. So what we got here? 40 is to 3. So what is the ratio? 40 is to 3. See this example. 2 does not is to 42. Okay. Now this is given in dozen and this is just given number. Okay. Means 42 things. Suppose. Okay. 2 dozen is to 42 things. Now 1 dozen means how much it is? 1 dozen banana. In 1 dozen banana, how many bananas we get? 12. Okay, 1 dozen. In 1 dozen we get 12. 1 dozen means 12 things. Then 2 dozen means 24 things. Okay, see, 1 dozen is equal to 12. In 1 dozen, we are getting anything you can take in 1 dozen. Suppose A, in 1 dozen how much eggs we are getting? 12 eggs we are getting. So 1 dozen means 12 things. Okay. Then 2 dozen means, see, in 1 dozen we are getting 12. Then 2 multiple by 12. So 2 dozen means 24. Okay. So 2 dozen means 24 things. So what we have to find? We have to find the ratio. 2 dozen is 242. What we have to find? We have to find the ratio. 2 dozen is 242. Now 2 dozen means how much we got? 24. See what we have to find? We have to find the ratio. 2 dozen is 242. So for 2 dozen how much we got? 24 things. Okay. 24 is 242. So we have to find the ratio. 24 is 242. Understood? See, it is given in dozen and it is given just in number. So 1 dozen means 12 things, then 2 dozen means 24 things. So we have to find the ratio. 2 dozen is to 42. So 2 dozen means 24. Yes, so 24 is to 42. So let's find the ratio. Okay, so required ratio. Required ratio is equal to 24 upon 42. Okay. 24 is to 42 means we have to write this ratio in fraction. 24 upon 42. Okay? Now 24 upon 42. So 24 upon 42. See. 142. Now if you will see, x1 plus is 2 and here it is 4. So both the numbers are divisible by 2. So divide by 2. 2 2's are 4, 2 1's are 2. 2 1's are 2, 2 2's are 4. So what we got? 12 upon 21. Now both the number comes in which table? Which same table? Both the numbers are divisible by 3. In 3 table also 12 comes and in 3 table 21 also comes. Okay. In 3 table 21 also comes and in 3 table 12 is also comes. So 3 7's are 21, 3 4's are 12. So what ratio we have got? 4 is to 7. Okay. So what ratio we have got? 4 is to 7. So next example. 3 feet is to 12 inches. Now this is given in feet and this is given in inches. Okay. This is given in feet and this is given in 1 feet is equal to 12 inches. Okay, 1 feet is equal to 12 inches. Then 3 feet, we have to find for 3 feet, na? So we should know for 1 feet how much inch. Okay, 1 feet means 12 inch. 1 feet means 12 inch. Then 3 feet means 3 feet. For 1 feet, 12. Then for 3 feet, how much? So for 3, we will multiply by 12. Why we multiply by 12? Because 1 feet means 12 inches. So for 1 feet, 12. And for 3 feet, how much inch? So for 3, we will multiply by 12. So for 3 feet, 36. 12 threes are 36 inches. Okay. So now what we have to do? We have to find the ratio. 3 feet is to 12 inches. We have to find the ratio. 3 feet is to 12 inches. Now 3 feet, how much we got? 3 feet means 36 inches we got. 3 feet means 36 inches we got. So 36 inches is to, see, 3 feet. 3 feet means 36 inches. We have to find the ratio. 3 feet is to 12 inches. 3 feet means 36 inches. It's to 12 inches. 12 inches. Okay. So write this ratio as a fraction. So required ratio
to 2.
Now write this 5 is to 2. This ratio we have to write as a fraction 5 upon 2. So find the equivalent ratio for this given ratio. We have to multiply by 2 for the numerator as well as denominator. 5 2's are 10, 2 2's are 4. So what we got? 10 is to 4. So which ratio we got? 10 is to 4. Now we have to find 3, na? So let's take 5 is to 2. 5 upon 2 right ratio as a fraction. Now here we multiply by 2, here we will multiply by 3 for numerator and denominator. So 5 3's are 15, 2 3's are 6. So what we got? 15 is to 6. 15 is to 6. Now one more we need. See, it is not like that. I have taken here 2, so you also take it 2. You can multiply here by 5 also. See, means see, 5 upon 2. Now here I see, here we multiply by 3. Here you can multiply by 5 also. But for numerator and for denominator, you have to multiply with same number. You can multiply for numerator and denominator by 6 also. You can multiply by 7 also for numerator as well as denominator. Means the number which we are going to multiply for numerator is the same number we have to multiply for the denominator. Okay. So now here I will multiply by 4. So 5 4s are 20, 2 4s are 8. So what ratio we got? 20 is to 8. Okay.